Hi friends, in today's video we will be seeing how to apply for Indian government's education loan scheme Vidyalakshmi, and I will also demonstrate how to fill in the application form online. To always stay connected with my channel regarding the updates of education system or research, you can always subscribe to my channel and press the notification bell nearby and keep updated with me. Vidyalakshmi Education Loan Portal. It's a loan portal that is maintained by NSDL. NSDL is National Security Depository Limited. It's an Indian central depository system that is available in Mumbai. It's a public sector depository. Here, this Vidyalakshmi portal is working in accordance with the norms that is framed by NSDL e-governance scheme. It's a technology for a better governance and administration. Apart from this education loan system, they also work on PAN related works, IT related works, income tax related works, etc. And with regard to Vidyalakshmi education scheme, it success stories, it completes 1 year of its operation and more than 1 lakh students is benefited throughout India. This scheme is called as Pradhan Mantri Vidyalakshmi Karyakram. Karyakram means program. This portal is developed under the guidance of Department of Financial Services, Ministry of Finance, Department of Higher Education, Ministry of Human Resource and Development, Indian Banks Association. In 2015-16, in the budget speech of our Finance Minister Arun Jaitley, he said 54% of total population in India is below 25 years. And the aim and ambition of our Honorable Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi is making India scheme. This could be possible only with the skillful mind and intellectual people minds within India. So they thought of opening an education web portal and they set up a fully IT based, information technology based student financial aid to maintain and monitor the scholarship and education loans under the scheme. This is the web portal, how it will be looking like. And if you need to apply, you can go to that register column that is available. Nearly 40 banks is registered with this portal and 71 loan schemes are available. The web address is provided here, and also I will provide the web address below this video in the description column of the video, and you can get connected with the Vidyalakshmi web portal. And once you press the register column, and these are the details that you require to, that you need to fill in. Title, Mr. Miss, whatever it is. And first name, last name is mandatory. Middle name, if you had any, you can enroll in it. First name will obviously be your name, and last name will obviously be your family name or your father's name. Mobile number, a valid mobile number, 10-digit mobile number is necessary. Email ID should be valid and it need to be validated and verified. And this portal will also verify your email ID. So that need to be verified within 24 hours as soon as you have enrolled here. Password, what you type in must be between 8 to 14 letters. Password should contain the combination of alphabets, numbers and special characters. Password and email ID should not be the same. And once you enter the password, you have to enter the CAPTCHA what is available, and you need to choose the agree button and you can submit it. And a mail will be sent to the mail ID which you have enrolled here, and that mail need to be validated. And once you are back to this particular Vidyalakshmi portal, you can log in. The login will be having two sections, one for student login and the other for the bank login. You need to enroll into the student login if you are applying for the education loan, wherein you can type the Gmail ID or whatever the ID you have verified and the password what you have typed in this particular web page of Vidyalakshmi at the time of registration. And you have to enter the CAPTCHA and you can log in. This is the web page, how it will be looking like once you have logged in. And from that particular step, I will show you how to proceed with it. This is the web portal, how it will be looking like. First of all, search for the loan schemes. So once you go inside that search for loan scheme, this web page will be looking like this, wherein you can go for selection of location. I'm selecting it as India. You can select the course. I'm selecting it as undergraduate. And if it is below 4 lakhs, I'll be selecting here and I'll be going for search options. And that will be showing several banks and their respective loan schemes. You can go accordingly, whichever is required. You can study each and individual loan scheme and you can find which is comfortable to you at a lower interest or a higher duration of period. After studying it, you can come into your conclusion and go for a particular loan scheme. Now I will, for an example, I will go for the State Bank SBI student loan scheme. I'll open it. And here is the name of the loan. Here is a short description about it. Here the repayment date is 15 years. So if I find it better, it is up to 15 years, right? So my course will be 4 years and later I can pay for it. So repayment anytime between year 15 years should be done. So I will take the maximum duration and I will pay my loan, which I have secured for. I have tied to something around below 4 lakhs, right? So I will be doing it. What is the minimum criteria and whatever the interest they have mentioned here. If it is up to 7.5 lakhs, the rate of interest is just 10%. And if it is above, means it is 10.75. So for female candidates, they are giving a concession for it also. You can avail whichever is convenient for you. If there is any processing fee, no prepayment charges. So accordingly, which scheme is best for you, you can choose it and later you can come into a conclusion and later you can fill in the application form. The application form will be having the details like personal information of yours, your parents, and if it is a guarantor, you need to enter the guarantor if you are applying the loan about 7.5 lakhs. And all the details that is required here. Present the details of the means in which you are holding an account. It need not be the same account what the bank you are applying the loan for. It can be different. What is the course you are going to study, and this particular detail will be provided by you in the institutions. For number of years, what will be the fees and what is the loan that is required, you can calculate it, and they will be providing in their letterhead, and that you need to upload in the upload section. And how much installments you would like to pay, that you can come into a conclusion according to the banker details. Here is the personal information, what you'll be feeding, what I told you just now, present our banker details, and they will be, once your loan is sanctioned, this particular account, all the money will be coming on to course details. What is the course you are going to study? You have to feed in here. Cost of the finance and details should be typed here. This will be provided by the institute where you are going to study. You need to upload all the documents that is necessary. If it is a polytechnic, you need to submit your 10th certificate. If it is an engineering course, you need to submit your 12th certificate. And you need to upload it here. Proof of admission, proof of income, etc., etc. Whichever is optional, you can neglect it. Rest of the things you need to submit it. Once you have submitted, you can see the application status in this particular web page. Here I have nothing enrolled. So after you are submitting it, your application status, it will be showing like you have submitted. you can see the progress in each step. If once the loan is sanctioned, you are eligible and the money will be coming out to your bank, and later you can proceed with your studies. If there is any grievances you are facing with the web page or with the bank, you can enroll your grievances here. That's it. This will be very simple in applying it. Indian government is providing you. Get benefited. Stay connected with my channel. If you like it, subscribe it. Notify. Press the notification bell and get the updates from me. Always share the video and benefit someone. Thank you.